was a dish fit for the Queen on her coronation, and this retro masterpiece is now making a very tasty comeback. Our very own Craigie Bennett is actually a bit of a whiz in the kitchen. He's here to make it for us this morning. Yay! Craig!
Sarah!
What are you making that is
well,
fit for a Queen?
This is retro, this is royal, this is regal, this is delicious. It's coronation chicken, which was created by Constance Spry and Rosemary Hume to Queens of the Kitchen in Britain for the Queen's coronation back in 1953. So that's why it's retro. It's been in, it's been out. It then became a very soggy sandwich filling in Britain, and all of a sudden, a bit like it's like the King Kong of the kitchen because it was
What's it called?
Coronation chicken. And it's now back, and it is dazzling and it is wonderful. Denise?
Yes.
What? Ah, there you go. You've got your very own crown, you see. What I'd like you to do is work your magic on this mango because coronation.
That was a potato.
No, beautiful
cheeks,
mango.
Cheeks first?
Yes. You're going to work your magic on those cheeks, mango cheeks. So skin off. We don't want the pip. Just some nice big chunks. Oh, I can smell that happening there. Let's get into it. Here's what we're doing, Sarah.
Yes.
This is basically a very elaborate, though simple, salad. Elaborate in terms of fabulous flavour, but very simple to pull together. I've poached a whole chicken. Very simple to do. In a pot of water, right, you plonk a chook, and then you pop in some cinnamon quills, you pop in some peppercorns, a bay leaf or two if you like, a little stock, maybe a slurp of wine. It's kind of up to you. You put the lid on and you let it very, very gently simmer for around about an hour, maybe an hour and a half, and then just let it cool in the liquid. Then you take the chook out of its wonderful bath, fabulously redolent with flavours. You peel off the skin, you chunk up the flesh, and this is how, that's what you wind up with.
How
it is the most juicy, moist, wonderful chicken.
Mm.
The superb centrepiece for this fabulous...
Is that how you want that?
That's lovely. Now we just need to take it off so we don't have any skin. Okay, next step is I've got some curry powder here and some finely chopped ginger. Now what I'm going to do is just bring up the flavours, and you do that by dry frying it. Just over some medium heat.
Like you would an Indian curry.
That's right. And you know yourself, because you're a great curry queen, how it is that the flavours really come out when you've just added some heat, some dry heat to the curry powder like that. That's enough. How do we turn that off, Denise? Because I'm not good at steering
this. Just put it there.
Fantastic. Lovely. OK, so we've got the curry all doing fabulously. Denise is working her magic on the mango. Now to the dressing. Very simple.
What's
we have in here equal quantities of mayonnaise, a good egg mayonnaise, you know, excellent egg mayonnaise, and a light sour cream, or you could use Greek yogurt, right, but not flavoured yogurt. So we give that a little bit of a mix to combine in with some fabulous mango chutney. Now, this too is nice and spicy, absolutely delicious.
Is that Mrs. Balls?
You can use Mrs. Balls, which is more of a peach chutney, but whatever. The mango chutney is great, but yes, Mrs. Balls I know and love. So that goes in there like that. See how simple this is? Now what we're doing is we're adding the curry powder, which has just been gently fried to release the flavours, and there is the fresh chopped ginger. So that gets combined. Right, very simple.
This is
can
quite
you
expensive.
Smell it, how gorgeous
it smells
it is?
Amazing. Can I do some combining?
You can do some combining. We're going to be adding to that some grapes. We're going to be adding to that the mango. We're going to be adding to that. Now, Denise, you'll need to cover your ears some coriander because I know you are not a coriander fan.
Oh.
But this just allows the flavours to really develop. You'll then fridge it up and that sharpens the flavours even further.
So should we pop in the grapes and the coriander
now? Well, we can do that. So in with
So we don't need to cut them in half.
No. Whole grapes is fantastic. Let me clear a bit of space
here
so I'm not working in
the mess. Isn't it?
Oh, well, it is. I mean, but 1953, what would you expect, you see?
Well, this is true.
But it's back now.
Do you think the Queen cooks it herself?
I tell you who used to love this dish, Denise, was Vivian Lee. Remember the great star, Blanche DuBois, A Streetcar Named Desire, and a little bit of that in there.
She was bipolar, but
she had a lot of troubles. No, you're absolutely right. A lot of troubles. Yeah, that can all go in there. That's absolutely perfect.
Do you think
the nuts don't go in?
Okay. Do you think Prince Phil gets this whipped up by the Queen every now and then?
I have a feeling that she would have her people whip this up for his people and it would work that way. And that's right. So there'd be an official taste.
You've brought this in from home, haven't you?
I have. Do you know, I was going to throw it out years ago. It's a bit of shocking old kitsch trash. And something inside me just said, don't do it, Craig. Don't throw that away, because I just had a feeling that, you know, Prince Philip and ER too might come back from the grave and haunt me forever. So we have that beautiful mayonnaise with the...
Do you know what
good
it smells
does that
like?
Smell?
It smells like salt and vinegar chips.
Does it really? Oh, yes, it does a little. But it does it when it's all happening. It's absolutely beautiful. Now, Denise, you have done a magnificent job with the mango. Look, you need to be in a bath for that, don't you? Isn't that how you eat mango?
Is that an invitation?
Maybe, or just a suggestion, since you've got your crown on.
I didn't want to waste it.
But isn't that how you eat the juiciest mangoes, is you lie in a bathtub and you strip them off and you're nude and away it goes? So, in with the mango there like that. Sarah,
tell us
more, Craig.
Yeah, okay. Oh, really?
The mango and the chicken?
Yeah, the mango and the chicken. We've got the grapes and the dressing.
And this is cooled in the fridge, hasn't it?
Oh, no, it all cools in the fridge once we've combined it together. So that goes over the top like that. Okie dokie. And
you could have chilled the wine.
I know I could have chilled the wine, but I'm like that. You can't do everything, Denise.
This looks delicious.
In here, this just pipes up the flavour a little
too.
What is it? Just a little splash of Worcestershire sauce.
Oh.
Right? Absolutely lovely. Now we combine this together like that. I know it looks like a mess. It might look like wallpaper paste, but it will be absolutely beautiful. And what we're going to do is we're going to plate this up. We are going to make it look absolutely magnificent.
Yep.
There shall be a scattering of slivered almonds over that, and voila! Fit for a queen,
Bob's
and then
uncle.
Some. Bob's your uncle and Bertie's your aunt.
Craig.
Look at that, eh? Feast your eyes, folks.
Yum.
How fantastic does that look?
You say it's the coronation chicken, but with all that mayonnaise, it looks like coronary chicken.
That's all right. Something's got to take you.
We
all wind up gathered. Why not with, you know, having had a delicious meal? Now, toasted slivered almonds over the top of that.
Yum.
I mean, honestly, right, could anything be more decadent and delicious?
But
absolutely not.
Fabulous lunch idea. I love this with the festive season
fabulous.
Coming up.
Ike is a big fan, lunch. Aren't you?
Mm. Yeah.
And people now, how is that?
Oh, perfect.
How are those flavours?
Mm.
There you go, you see.
Oh, I love it. Don't you like it, Sarah?
Mm. Oh, Sarah.
No.
I promise you I shan't be offended.
I have Sarah.
That's all right. I'll go home and cry.
I have Sarah.
He was chicken.
What is it about it that you don't like,
Sarah? I thought it was...
A little bit of chalk.
Never mind.